How does a fractional laser work when removing sun-damaged skin? For sun-damaged skin, if someone has not only the fractional treatment, but any fractional laser to resurface the skin and maybe remove small bits of sun-damaged skin, how does this treatment work in removing the sun-damaged skin? Does the sun-damaged skin, after 3 to 4 sessions, completely disappear 100% or not? How effective are not only Fraxel, but many other fractional lasers at removing small bits of sun-damaged skin? What if the results are not to the patient's satisfaction? What could be done then in that case? Microneedling PRP or some other treatment to remove the sunburn damage on the skin? Can anyone tell me?
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question without any photos, which means, of course, that I don't have any details and specifics of your situation, but you're asking basically how does a fractional laser effectively treat sun-damaged skin? And of course, the further follow-up questions within your submitted question is about the effectiveness as well as the other options in case it doesn't work out the way you like, such as microneedling and PRP. It's very understandable where the confusion comes from about dealing with sun-damaged skin. So I'll try to help you by giving you a global understanding of how I counsel my patients who come with this type of issue. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. We have many solutions in our practice, everything from skin products to minimally invasive technologies, including lasers of different kinds, radiofrequency technology, PRP, etc., as well as full-service surgical solutions. So we deal with a lot of situations which fall under the umbrella of sun-damaged skin. So let's start by defining what is sun-damaged skin. Sun-damaged skin usually refers to problems with discolorations. So when people spend a certain amount of time in the sun, whether it's intentionally, such as for tanning, or secondarily or incidentally, just by living in a place where sun exposure is intense and unavoidable, the smoothness and continuity and tone of the skin becomes affected by discolorations. The other part of sun-damaged skin is about loss of skin quality, which means the development of wrinkles, the loss of the luster of the skin, and as well as the breakdown of collagen within the skin, which also results in the increase in appearance of vessels. So we'll start with just basically dealing with trying to get luster and treating discolorations. When you talk about where we have come from, the first lasers that we were using back in the mid-90s, the original CO2 laser, basically the idea was to resurface the skin, take off the top layer of skin, and let new skin come through. Now, of course, that was already being done for decades with chemical peels. And the chemical peels were basically graded as light, medium, or deep chemical peels, glycolic acids to TCA peels to phenol, Baker-Gordon peels. So what was the difference with lasers? Well, lasers gave us a certain amount of flexibility when it came to being able to control depth in different areas. Certainly you can do that with chemical peels, but there was a certain control that was achievable with lasers, which was very nice, as well as the selectiveness of the use of these lasers on certain target structures. In addition, lasers generate thermal energy, which causes a little tightening effect. So move the clock forward, and what was the challenge back then, just going back to the original CO2 laser? It was healing time. Basically, we were treating patients essentially with who are having second degree burns and doing very burn focused wound healing strategies to help people heal. And that became problematic. Move the clock forward, and different lasers, such as the erbium laser, came along, and then fractional lasers came along. Fractional erbium, fractional CO2, with a wide range of flexibility. What you're effectively doing with a fractional laser is you are reducing the amount of injury to the skin, therefore allowing faster healing, making it more controllable. You can also go from very, very light to medium to deep, as well as with those different depths, you can also go into different levels of heat. So there's a wide range, and it gives us a lot of flexibility. Now, the concept, of course, is to try to even out the skin. And when you're trying to even out the skin, even though the skin is not very thick, we're looking at about 2 millimeters of thickness, you want to balance out the relative amount of discomfort, the amount of the time it takes to heal, and the recovery and being able to get back to normal life sooner rather than later. So in addition to the fractional technology, we also have non-ablative laser technology, such as a Q-switch laser that is able to treat pigment very effectively without taking off the top layers of skin. So certainly there's a lot of ways to really help people with sun-damaged skin. But it's very important to understand that treating skin, and a very well-known dermatologist stated this, he said that essentially you never cure anything in dermatology, you make things better. And the point of saying something like that, it really brings home the critical aspect of treatment when it comes to helping skin that is affected by the sun. It's more about management and not just a single procedure. So in the modern world, what we have done essentially is we've integrated combination therapies. So when it comes to the lasers, what I would do is combine something like a fractional laser with something called PRP, or platelet-rich plasma. Platelet-rich plasma is derived from your own blood. It's a concentration of wound healing and growth factors, and it does a lot of the things that we try to do with lasers in terms of stimulating collagen, improving the quality of the skin, stimulating the fat cells under the skin, which you can't do with the laser, and you get healthier looking skin. And so I've developed in my practice a style which is more about minimizing the invasiveness of the laser, but creating synergistic approach to helping people with sun-damaged skin, which is about a management or treatment plan. So with that comes very important guidance in terms of the use of sunblock, the use of different types of therapeutic topicals, and having patients come in for regular follow-ups. And again, between the fractional laser technology, Q-switch technology, PRP, and skin products, essentially we're able to make a significant difference and improvement, and we're able to document that. But every patient situation has to be customized. The relatively young male with, let's say, brown skin, or let's say type 4 skin, versus the middle-aged to older female with type 1 to type 2 skin, lighter skin types, blue eyes, light skin, we're going to be treating very differently. So you can't necessarily apply the same strategy to everyone. You actually have to customize it. And a lot of times what I help patients try to understand is in cosmetic dermatologic treatment, you also treat and you observe and you see how patients respond. And microneedling is not to be overlooked, and you mentioned that in your question. Microneedling also has a valuable potential benefit, particularly when combined with PRP when it comes to like fine wrinkles around the eyes or just a generalized improvement on the skin, whether it's the neck skin or the facial skin. So I think you need to just meet with doctors and get some ideas about what the strategy is. But understand it's more about a longer-term treatment plan than it is about a single device or transaction. In the modern world of medispas and strip mall centers of skin treatment, there's a lot of people offering packages and things to try to get people in the door and just do a one-off treatment. And eventually patients keep bouncing from place to place looking for solutions. So meet with doctors and get the feel on whether or not the interaction with the doctor is more about a long-term strategy and a long-term relationship rather than a one-off transactional relationship. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.